So my name is Kathleen Sexton, and I am the program manager at the Clinton River Watershed Council. So I'm going to talk to you guys today about the Watershed Council, a little bit of an introduction to the Clinton River Watershed and Lake St. Clair, what a watershed is, and how we can protect our watershed and ways that you guys can get involved. So a little bit of history. About 45 years ago, the Clinton River was in trouble. It was highly polluted. There was a lot going on in terms of industrial pollution and individual pollution. And in 1972, there was an association of local governments and wastewater treatment plants that formed the council. And the Clean Water Act was also passed that same year in 1972, which further encouraged participation and bringing the health of our water resources to the forefront and making that a priority. And so today, in 2020, the Watershed Council functions as a nonprofit organization, and we work to protect, enhance, and celebrate the Clinton River, its watershed, and Lake St. Clair. And we do that by focusing on three main program areas: education, stewardship, and watershed management. So I've been saying the word watershed a lot. So what is a watershed? Essentially, it's an area of land that drains into a common body of water. So the Clinton River watershed is 760 square miles. So all of the water bodies, the precipitation, the streams, drains, creeks, and groundwater in that area eventually converge into the main branch of the river, and that flows into Lake St. Clair. So the Clinton River watershed covers four counties in southeast Michigan, parts of Oakland, Macomb, Lapeer, and St. Clair County. It encompasses over 63 communities in the watershed proper, as well as 12 additional communities in Lake St. Clair, direct drainage, and the Anchor Bay watershed. So our watershed is actually one of the most densely populated watersheds in the state, with 1.5 million people, and its parts of it are very urbanized and developed. So the Clinton River is actually a connection to the Great Lakes. So if we start out here in Clinton Township, we are in the Clinton River East subwatershed, which eventually goes into the main branch of the Clinton River, which then goes into Lake St. Clair. Lake St. Clair is connected to Lake Erie via the Detroit River. And then Lake Erie is connected to Lake Ontario, which is ultimately connected to the Atlantic Ocean. So we are a passage to the Great Lakes as well as to the ocean. And so I just want to touch on a few facts about the Great Lakes, because I don't think you can talk about water quality in Michigan without mentioning the Great Lakes. It holds 20% of the entire freshwater supply in the world and 90% of the freshwater supply in the United States. And Michigan itself has 3,288 miles of shoreline. And there's only one state in the union that has more shoreline than Michigan. It's Alaska. So we have more shoreline than Florida and California combined, which is pretty amazing. It's a great resource to have here. It brings a lot of value to our economy based on recreation, tourism, fishing, the marine industry, as well as clean drinking water for our residents and our community. So we're going to focus a little bit on Clinton Township, and we're going to talk about the sub-watershed that it's housed in. So a sub-watershed is just a smaller watershed that feeds the main branch of the Clinton River. So you can essentially break things down into smaller and smaller pieces. So the Great Lakes Basin is one big watershed, and then you can break that down into smaller watersheds like the Clinton River, which then can be even broken down farther into sub-watersheds. They each have unique characteristics, and so we're going to talk a little bit about the East Branch sub-watershed. It's a very popular paddling destination. There's lots of riverside parks like Dodge Park, Bud Park, Canal Park, and Riverbends Park, as well as parts of the main branch of the river that go through downtown Utica, Mount Clemens, and other communities. It's also the Clinton River East subwatershed includes the mouth of the river in Harrison Township and 7 miles of Lake St. Clair shoreline. Lots of recreational water resources available here for the community to experience and to appreciate. It's 130 square miles out of the total 760 square mile watershed. It's located in Macomb County, as you guys know probably, and there's over 300,000 people living there, and there's lots of open water sources. There's actually 128 linear miles of open channel drains, the middle branch of the Clinton River, parts of the main branch of the Clinton River, the Clinton River spillway, and as I mentioned, lots of 7 miles of Lake St. Clair shoreline. That's a bit of background about the Clinton River and its watershed. So now we're going to talk about some of the water quality problems that we're facing and what we do at the Watershed Council to try to address those problems. So some of the things that currently affect water quality in the Clinton River are bacterial contamination from combined sewer overflows and failing septic systems, some persistent contaminated sediments from the before the Clean Water Act and things that haven't been cleaned up yet because it's not clear who's responsible for cleaning them up or there's no funding to clean them up. Flooding from increased severity of storms and things like that. Chemical pollution from pesticide use, fertilizer, excess salt, and other nutrients that are actually going into the water. But the biggest source of contamination and water quality impairment for the Clinton River is stormwater pollution. So what is stormwater pollution? It's actually a non-point source type of pollution, which means it's a collective result of individual behaviors. Basically, when it rains or snow melts and all of that runoff runs off of impervious surfaces, which an impervious surface is something that water cannot go through. So roofs, driveways, parking lots, vehicles, mowed lawns, things like that, the water is actually not going to absorb into those surfaces. It's going to run off of it. And then that water collects things along the way. So pollutants like animal waste, fertilizer that people use on their yards, pesticides that people use or farmers use, oil and grease from vehicles, salt from salting the roads in the winter, which these are all things that are necessary for everyday life. But when we have 1.5 million people contributing to these pollutants on impervious surfaces, it leads to a lot of pollution going into the Clinton River. So when the water runs off, it's collected in a storm drain or a catch basin, and it goes into the storm sewer system. So storm sewer systems are necessary to prevent flooding and basements from backing up with stormwater when it rains, but it can be detrimental to our water quality since often this stormwater is directly channeled into our local waterways untreated. So when you think about the water that you use in your home, so if you're using the kitchen sink or the bathroom or taking a shower or doing laundry, that water is captured by a sanitary sewer system. It gets transported to a wastewater treatment plant and it gets treated before it's discharged back into Lake St. Clair or another local water body where it's then taken up again and treated for drinking water sources or other sources of water. But stormwater is different in that it's basically just taking away the runoff, getting it out of the streets and neighborhoods as fast as we can, and then channeling it into our local drainage ways. Which, as I mentioned before, the reason that this is a problem is it is a lot of water, so high volume of water coming in quickly, which leads to erosion. It decreases wildlife habitat because there's a lot of pollutants and it's a different temperature. It's usually a higher temperature than what aquatic life is supported by. They like colder temperatures. As I mentioned, a lot of pollutants. It causes flooding. Excess nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus that we find in fertilizers cause algal blooms and other water quality issues. So as I mentioned, stormwater is a collective result of all of individual people that live within the watershed. So it's the responsibility of everyone to keep our waterways clean. It doesn't just fall on one specific organization or individual. It's everybody's responsibility. As I mentioned, there's 1.5 million people in the watershed, which means there's thousands of storm drains and hundreds of thousands of gallons of stormwater every time it rains. So there's small actions that you can commit to in your everyday life that make a big difference overall. So some of the ways that you can get involved in protecting your water, talk to your friends and families and coworkers about what you learned today from this show. That's a great way to spread the word. Talk to them about the Clinton River Watershed Council and what we're doing. You can also plant a tree. Trees are really great at intercepting stormwater and helping it soak into the ground instead of running off. You can volunteer at the Clinton River Watershed Council, and I'll talk to you guys a little bit more about those volunteer opportunities coming up. If you see trash on the ground, pick it up, even if it's not yours, and dispose of it properly, as opposed to letting it get channeled into a storm drain and then ultimately into the Clinton River and Lake St. Clair. And another thing you can do is become River Safe, Lake Safe. So River Safe, Lake Safe is an educational campaign that we have at the Watershed Council, where we educate watershed residents on best management practices that they can do at their home that help reduce their impact to water quality. So things related to native landscaping, fertilizer use, washing your vehicle or your boat, household hazardous waste, and also even taking steps to install green infrastructure at home, like rain gardens, rain barrels, and green roofs. So some of the volunteer opportunities that we have at the Watershed Council are through our Keeping It Clean program. This is a trash cleanup program that includes people of all ages, and we get together and we clean up trash from areas in the watershed. Sometimes we do this in kayaks and canoes, sometimes it's at parks, but it's always a lot of fun and we get a lot of trash picked up and disposed of properly. Another option for volunteering is our Adopt a Stream program. So Adopt a Stream is a citizen science program where we train local community members or watershed residents on how to monitor a stream in their local watershed. And we do this twice a year in the spring and the fall, and volunteers assemble a team and they go out and they do their monitoring and they bring the results back to the Watershed Council office. And then we put a report together and we look at what we found. And it's a great way for us to get a lot of boots on the ground because we are a pretty small staff at the Watershed Council and get a lot of baseline data. So we've been doing this program for almost 20 years, which means we have data that dates back 20 years. And so we catalog it, we monitor any changes. And then if we do see a change or something that seems out of the ordinary, we have an opportunity to go recognize that and see what's going on and see if there's something that we need to do. Other ways that you can get involved is becoming a member. So it's a donation to become a member, and then you're gonna be supporting our programs and services that we provide to the local communities. You'll also be recognized in our annual report, and you'll be receiving our biannual newsletters throughout the year. And there's other volunteer opportunities, such as a road stream crossing monitoring, our salt watch monitoring, and our native plant sale in June every year. So some of our upcoming trainings, if you want to get involved in Adopt a Stream, there's three happening in March. One is in East Point, one's in Shelby Township, and one is in Centerline, as well as in Orion. And then we have every year, or twice a year, our bug ID training. So this is the Adopt a Stream training, as well as certification and identifying the aquatic bugs that live in the stream. And that's gonna be on April 4th at our office from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. It's a lot of fun. It's a very interesting opportunity. Don't be intimidated by the phrase citizen science. Anybody can do this. And we need you guys to volunteer. We need more Adopt a Stream volunteers and people like you to get involved in protecting the watershed.
Hi, I'm Kim Meltzer, Clinton Township Clerk, and I'm excited to be here with Kathleen Sexton. She's the Program Manager for the Clinton River Watershed Council. And Kathleen, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
And we're going to talk about water quality, what is a watershed, and many other topics. So let's get started and educate the public of Clinton Township and invite them to get involved and participate in what is a responsibility for all of us here in Clinton Township.
Absolutely. Sounds good.
So why don't we start off with the first question is, you know, what is a watershed and how does Clinton Township become involved?
So a watershed is essentially just an area of land that drains to a common body of water. So in this case, we're talking about the Clinton River watershed, which the main branch of the Clinton River eventually ends up in Lake St. Clair. And Lake St. Clair is the drinking water source for 4 million people in Southeast Michigan and Canada. So it's really important that we make sure that we're taking care of that water and keeping it clean and healthy for the environment and for human health.
How is it that Clinton Township's involved with the Watershed Council itself, the Clinton River Watershed Council, which is hosted in Rochester Hills, correct?
Yes.
That's with your host, the board meetings, and I am involved as well. But give us some more, give the public a little bit more insight in terms of how Clinton Township is involved in the Watershed Council.
Clinton Township is a government member of the Watershed Council. They're a stormwater education member, and they're also one of our water towns. So water towns is a community development program where we work with municipalities, we help them get connected to their water resources, and we do that in a variety of ways, whether it's community development, art and culture and history, green infrastructure, and just new ideas to incorporate water resources while also managing stormwater in the community. So Clinton Township has done two projects already, a native shoreline planting at the pond here at the Township Hall, as well as redevelopment of the parking lot with some green infrastructure installations at the Township Hall as well.
So the pond in front of the municipality is where people come in and the residents come in and people from outside of Clinton Township come in to do fishing and participate in some of the programs that Parks and Recs puts on. Mm-hmm. And so having that in that habitat changed somewhat a little bit brought a lot of awareness of how important what surrounds the watershed and what and how that impacts. What is it that you see as a value to that addition to that part of the pond?
Well, the native shoreline planting, not only is it beautiful, but it helps keep geese away. It helps enhance the water quality in the pond. When stormwater is running off, it gets filtered and intercepted. And the pond project, as well as the township parking lot project, have sort of paved the way for new projects happening in Clinton Township. So Mary Bednar, the Director of Public Works, is now incorporating different practices and green infrastructure into new stormwater management developments. And it's just really paved the way for a new way of thinking in terms of development in the township.
Mary Bednar does a phenomenal job and keeps us all updated on what new technologies or what new practices, best practices there could be for us to comply with keeping our waters healthy, mm-hmm. as well as the habitat. And she's a great asset to the township. Mm-hmm. So it's exciting for me to be a part of the Clinton River Watershed Council, to have her to sit down with and discuss, you know, these new endeavors and what we can do in the future to not only help Clinton Township immediately, but be a great example, be that steward to other communities. And I think Clinton Township has spearheaded and been a great example for other communities to be involved. Mm-hmm. And I know you work with other communities, but how do we compare to those other communities in terms of our water quality awareness?
I would say Clinton Township, as you mentioned, they're definitely one of the community leaders in terms of protecting the watershed and protecting the Clinton River and bringing value to the river and showing residents what it can provide them in terms of recreation and just an overall better quality of life. And the Clinton River Watershed Council works with a lot of different municipalities within the watershed. We help provide educational services for them to comply with their stormwater permits. And there's a variety of different levels of involvement, but we're always looking for communities to get more involved and really take that next step and getting boots on the ground and implementing something in their community that's going to help protect water quality.
One of the things that I think is really fun and what I'd love to see more residents of Clinton Township become involved with is our river cleanup. And that's where we can get into the water on canoes and kayaks and just go along the shoreline and clean up the debris that has accumulated. And every year I keep thinking, oh, we're not going to have any debris this time because we accumulated and brought up so much the previous year. But every year there's more and more. So mm-hmm. we have seen a reduction, though, mm-hmm. as we've been keeping it up and cleaning annually. But that River Cleanup Day is such a fun day. Mm-hmm. You are a great help in making that happen. Yeah. And it really is a great asset to our community and getting people involved and more aware. Mm-hmm. So that's one thing that I love to participate in that. Yeah. It's in June, I think, the first week in June. Is that generally we have it?
We have River Day in June, and that's where we have our native plant sale. But we also have the Clinton Cleanup in September, which is going to be September 19th this year, and we do it at Bud Park, and we get in canoes and kayaks. Last year we did it. It was a lot of fun.
It was.
I think we had some students from some local universities come out.
Yeah, Oakland University. Yeah, mm-hmm. they participated pretty heavily.
Yeah, they had a strong presence there. But there's always different events coming up. We have a lot of cleanups happening on River Day, and throughout the summer we have trash runs. So we actually put volunteers in canoes and we go down the river, we collect trash along the way, and it's pretty amazing some of the things that you can find in the river?
This resource that we have in Clinton Township, in my opinion, is the best resource that we have in Clinton Township. And we've been talking about that as a board and as just community leaders in our community. Been talking about what are the things that Clinton Township is known for? What are the things that we can capitalize on? And by far, in my opinion, it's our water, our Clinton River watershed. And not only because of the economic opportunities, but recreational and quality of life issues. I think it's fabulous. And as a result of that, we have a responsibility mm-hmm. to be involved. And the public does have a responsibility because the health of our water system helps all of us. And mm-hmm. so we really want to encourage everyone in Clinton Township, if they can, even by doing little things, picking up trash that may not belong to you, but somehow somebody dropped it, or maybe the wind blew it from a trash receptacle. It doesn't necessarily mean people are being irresponsible, but things happen. And so if you see garbage, get involved, pick it up, and find the right way to get rid of it mm-hmm. so that it doesn't get into our water system. That's just one little way people can help. But you talked about how we can make sure that we're limiting our phosphorus and nitrogen applications on our fertilizers, our oil, you know, from the cars that comes out, those non-source point pollution mm-hmm. Contributions. And when you have such a large group of people in a small area of community like Clinton Township, where we have residents of over 100,000, you're going to see more concentration of pollution. Mm-hmm. So everybody has to be involved. So if you could touch on maybe some other ideas for the public to be involved, that would be, I think they would love to hear that.
The next one we have coming up is actually protecting water quality in cold weather. So it's talking about cold weather, best management practices that you can follow at home. We also have a native landscaping for pollinators workshop coming up. And we're going to be talking about the Powsheik skipperling butterfly. It's actually endangered. And talking about how some of the things that we can do to protect its habitat. And another landscaping for pollinators and water quality on March 25th at the Senior Center in Clinton Township. And we also have rain gardens and rain barrels workshop coming up in Clinton Township on April 20th. And also Adopt a Stream, which is our citizen science program. So if you guys want to get involved, please reach out to the Watershed Council. And we'd love you to become a member and donate to help us to help fund our programs and services and show support for your watershed. So lots of ways that you can get involved, and we'd love to have you guys.
It's really important for the public to know that we want them involved, but also an integral part of a successful campaign is the fundraising part of it. So we do that in fun ways. The Clinton River Watershed Council offers opportunities to be involved and having fun while they're making a financial contribution. Mm-hmm. I can think of three off the top. Can you go ahead and expound upon those?
So yes, there's Zoo Walk, which is our fundraiser in July. There's Crafts on the Clinton, which is our fundraiser in the fall. And the annual meeting, which is actually coming up on April 2nd, we do need funding for these services, and communities need funding to help maintain and improve their water infrastructure. So it's vital that residents get involved in that capacity.
So becoming a member of the Clinton River Watershed Council for $35 is a small contribution for some folks. If they could contribute that way, that's a great way. And then in addition, what they get in return is the information about what's happening with the Watershed Council and what's happening in the community in terms of water quality.
Yep, absolutely. So like Kim said, we'd love to have you guys get involved. So if you want to become a member, you can visit our website, crwc.org, or feel free to give us a call at 248-601-0606, and we'll be happy to get you guys started on protecting your watershed.
Kathleen, thank you so much for being here today, for the presentation you've given, and for educating the public on how important our water quality is. Thank you.
Thank you, Kim.
All right.